Hello and welcome back for another edition of Dyca Tv with me, Isaac Grinnell,
and me, Sky Portman. It's Friday the 24th of January 2014. Coming up in today's show.
As we begin 2014, we'll be looking back at the New Year's celebrations from across the globe.
Our reporters asked DYCA staff and students about their New Year's resolutions.
We'll find out about the upcoming Chinese New Year.
And we'll be finding out why scientists are saying that the sun has gone to sleep.
All this and more. But first, Sky will take us through the New Year's celebrations from across the world.
Thank you, Isaac. 2014 started with a bang, with countries all over the world competing for glory. Millions of people around the globe gathered to celebrate as major cities competed to hold the most spectacular displays.
Yes, they were stunning, but how much did they cost?
I knew you'd ask that, Isaac. The 11-minute display in London cost us about £1.8 million.
That's quite a lot, isn't it?
Yes, it is. But it's a very nice way to start the new year, and the display was amazing. It even included smell-o-vision, so that when people saw the fireworks, they could smell different flavoured sweets according to the colour of the lights.
That sounds good. I must say, I enjoyed them. But did you see the other displays from different countries? Let's have a look at the competition.
At the start of a new year, many people like to set themselves goals and targets that they will try to achieve in the coming year.
These New Year's resolutions are a good opportunity to make positive changes to our lives, although sometimes they are broken pretty quickly.
What was your resolution, Isaac?
My resolution was to achieve high grades in all my subjects.
And how's it going?
It's going quite well, Sky, but I find it hard sometimes.
We sent our reporters to find out What New Year's resolution DYCA staff and students set themselves this year, and how they are doing at keeping to them?
I made two. One was not to eat puddings, which I failed miserably at, and the second one was to take my son Zach swimming more, which I have done so far.
Made several, but one in particular I have done, and hoping to continue to do that within the year.
And what's that?
It's trying to get my house in order to be a much tidier house and a peaceful house.
Towards the end of last year, I decided I was coming a bit unfit, so I decided to start working out a bit more. So I've started at the moment to walk to work every day when it's not raining. And I'm starting to do the fitness thing, Insanity, so that will happen in the next couple of weeks. So it's really to get really fit, so I can do a half marathon towards the end of the year.
Miss, have you made any New Year's resolutions?
New Year's resolutions? I don't actually make New Year's resolutions. The reason for that is that I always feel that if I make a New Year's resolution to either swim a bit more or, you know, go to keep fit or have a healthy diet, and I don't do it, and I've told everybody that I'm doing this and I don't do it, then I feel like I've let myself down a bit. So I keep behind the scenes secretly saying I'll keep fit, but I won't tell anybody.
Just to try and be the best person that I can be on a daily basis.
Yeah, my New Year's resolution is to become more organised.
Good luck to all those who made New Year's resolutions. Keep it up. Now, January the 31st is Chinese New Year.
Because Chinese people use the lunar calendar, their dates can change according to the new moon.
Let's find out more about this exciting celebration.
Next Friday, the 31st of January, will mark the Chinese New Year. In China, the years are marked according to the Chinese zodiac. 2014 will be the year of the horse, and it will be the year 4712 on the Chinese calendar. Each of them is named after an animal. This is similar to our signs of the zodiac. Some people believe that being born in a particular year will mean that you will have the same characteristics of the animal. There are 12 animals in total, and each of them has their own attributes.
Shu, mouse. Niu, ox. Hu, tiger. Tu, rabbit. Long, dragon. She, snake. Ma, horse. Yang, sheep. Ho, monkey. Ji, chicken. Go, dog. And Zhu, pig.
The Chinese calendar began thousands of years ago, when the Jade Emperor decided that there should be a way to measure time.
We'd like to wish all our Chinese friends a happy and successful New Year.
Now, something quite odd seems to be happening to the sun.
Yes, scientists are saying that the sun appears to be going to sleep and warning that if this inactivity continues, there could be far-reaching consequences from us on Earth.
Here's the latest.
Something strange is currently happening to the sun. Usually, the surface of the sun is covered with sunspots, exploding with flares and sending out huge clouds of charged particles into space. But recently, it has become very quiet, and in fact, it may be experiencing the most rapid decline in solar activity for 10,000 years. If you were to look at it through a telescope, you'd see a featureless yellow sphere. This has taken scientists by surprise, and many are wondering what the effect of this lull will be for us on Earth. This would not be the first time this has happened. In the 17th century, the sun went through an extremely quiet phase, a period called the Mondum Minimum. That era of solar inactivity coincided with a period of bitterly cold winters in Europe. Londoners held frost fairs on the River Thames, which completely froze over. Some describe it as a mini ice age. Some climate scientists believe that there is a chance that this would happen again if the sun continues to snooze. If solar activity is low, less UV radiation hits the stratosphere and disrupts the jet stream, which normally brings warmer, wetter weather across the Atlantic. This in turn brings freezing cold air from the Arctic, which then sits over North Europe. But colder weather is not a consequence of a period of solar inactivity. It would also mean there was a world be less displays of the spectacular northern lights, which are driven by solar activity. On a more positive note, there would be a less risk of damaging space weather that could affect satellites, electricity networks, radio communication and GPS. Everyone agrees that the sun is difficult to predict and it could spring back to life at any moment. But until it does, we are in a strange and unprecedented period. Evan Parker reporting for DYZA TV.
We'll be following this story as more information becomes known to us, so watch this space. Well, that's about it for today. But before we go, the author Mary Shelley once said,
"The beginning is always today."
This means that we should always be prepared to be beginners.
Knowing that every day brings us the opportunity to start afresh and make positive changes to our life.
Have a lovely weekend and see you soon for another DYCA TV. From all of us here, goodbye.